And we're back. Happy New Year to you. Welcome to 2015. I'm Darren Disbury. You're watching Thursday Thunder. Hopefully you're going to sit with us for the next hour while we talk about all things Speedway or parts thereof. If you have to, fast forward a bit that you need to watch. It's there to watch when you want to. Pleased to see Speed Week. What a fantastic run for the World Series guys. And Luke Dillon took the honours. Hurstie had the gold. Had it won, I guess. But tripped over the proverbial and was done. Congratulations to Luke and his team there. Fantastic. The wheels have fallen off with Speedway Oz. We talked about it last year. There was an alternative Speedway association trying to get itself up and running. I'm told the wheels have fallen off. I guess we'll hear more. Violence in our sport. Do we really have to put up with it in this day and age? I don't care who it is or who they think they are. To be throwing fists around the Speedway is just not on. If you want to fight, go and box. Not required in our sport. See you later. Goodbye. Injuries. 4 broken backs. Hope someone's looking into it. I know they're all just part of our racing and racing's dangerous, but please, someone look into it. I don't want to see my friends hurt unnecessarily if that's the case. Sydney Speedway is absolutely going off. If they're not leading the way, I don't know who possibly is. Stephen Green and his team are doing a fantastic job. 41 degree day, the track's dry and dusty. What do? Give free goggles to the people in the crowd. Great effort. Couple of nights later, had trouble with their clay per view, refunded all the money. Looking after the spectators. There's something new for Speedway, isn't it? I wonder if some of our other friends might like to look into that. Speedway Australia, congratulations to you. Absolutely thrilled in what you've done with World Series this year. From the turmoil that was during the off-season, great job to the people on the road. You're making the racing that we're proud of. Big thing at Clipsall this year, big display with Speedway Australia. Looking forward to seeing what they bring out there, should be good. And the Rising Star Camp, some interesting names among that for this year. April 14 to 16, heading off to the Institute. Let's see what comes of this year's Rising Stars. Toowoomba Speedway, the drums have been beating loud. Who's taking that over? Who's going to run it? Who's doing what where? Well, the Dragon spoke to Alan Woods today and he tells me he's got a lease for 3 years. The man knows his place. Alan Woods running that for the next 3 years. Australian Wingless title at Speedway City in a fortnight's time. South Australian title at Murray Bridge this week. There's only 60 cars nominated. Should we be concerned? Don't know. Question to be asked. $250 for the nominations. Might have scared a few people, but when you work out what that includes, their entry, their Calcutta, maybe not such a bad thing. 240 people talking to the Calcutta will be there for a feed and a bit of a chat. Who will be top dollar? We'll be interested to see where Pico puts his money on that night. We'll wait and see. 42 cars for the state title at Murray Bridge. Be interesting to see. Dean Gittos from West Australia. He's not coming over for the wingless title. Had a bit of a run-in with a wood chipper. Looks like the wood chipper might have won there. Get well soon, Dino. Like to see you back across here racing real soon. Spent some time at the Classic this year. Lots of tongues wagging. Is it missing something? Are we used to the spectacular thing that is the Classic? Normally the second round of heats is absolutely dynamic. You live for that with the fast guys from the back. This year it didn't deliver. I know the weather was cruel and the big display they had organised for the final wasn't able to happen because they were short on time with the rain. So I feel a little sorry for them there. But maybe the qualifying needs to be looked at. Do we need the time trials? Can't we just seed the guys? That's just the Dragon's opinion. Doesn't mean it's right. Probably doesn't mean it's wrong. But a lot of people sitting in that sun from early in the day to late the following morning. Talking about good things, the guys and girls that look after people up in the corporate area, they're up on the top of the hill at Mount Max at the Classic, good on you. do an absolutely super job. The guy that's the host, your name escapes me, I'm absolutely sorry about that, but fantastic job. So kudos to the club for pulling that together. However, there's a lady that does the security on the members gate. Please put a short little black moustache on and salute with your hand flat. If you're not the rudest person I've met in 2015 so far, I don't know who will be. Absolute disgrace. Again, my opinion. Hot weather with the Speedway. The Australian summer seems to be really tossing it up to us. At what point is it too hot to put people in race cars? I know there's policies in place and people want to keep racing, but at some point there's going to be issues with the heat. Everyone's got their choices to whether they run. Please, people, hydrate. We need you back at the track. Race directors, pay particular attention over Speed Week. The politeness and the way people were treated in the pits, the way they're called up for races and the way they're dealt with. In particular, the way it was done at Warrnambool. Hats off to them, very, very good. However, been to a couple of venues where the people, again, are absolutely rude. If you expect people to respect you when you talk to them the way you do, let alone leave them strapped in their cars for 20 minutes while you attend to the track, I don't know what you're thinking. It's got me absolutely beat. World Series Bunbury, it's all happening tonight. Hopefully, some good results there. Hot weather, tyre wear. Hopefully, it's all good there. Looking forward to a cracker finish to all that. Entertainment. Absolutely thrilled with the entertainment that Benny Bishop has brought to World Series. When he's gone out to the crowd during the breaks, involved the kids and the families, and even the impromptu dance routines, absolutely fantastic. Benny Bishop, a breath of fresh air with all things World Series. Credit to you, credit to World Series for what you've done there. Like it. Talking about entertainment, those of you that watch Super Bowl, you've got to check this out. This is how people entertain. First, I'm going to throw to an advert, Samo. It's called Best Buds. It tells a story. Feast your eyes on this.
When I wake up, well, I know I'm going to be. I'm going to be the man who wakes up next to you. And when I go out, yeah, I know I'm going to be. I'm going to be the man who goes along with you.
Congratulations to Budweiser, a fantastic advert. All about passion, people. It's all about passion. We also had McDonald's serving up there. Look at things. Done it a bit differently. I'm sure you're going to enjoy this. Sam, I roll the tape.
Hi, welcome to McDonald's. How can I help you?
Two hash browns and a small coffee.
You know what, for your payment today, do you have your cell phone with you?
Yeah.
Dial up your mom, tell your lover.
Excuse me?
Hey, Mom. Just wanted to let you know that I love you.
Te quiero mucho. How about you just tell me how much it is?
That is how much it is. Boom!
Your payment today will be telling me what you love about your son.
I love his compassion for other people.
The total says that she has to dance right now.
Oh, oh yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That strawberry sundae's waiting on you.
For a strawberry sundae.
You paid with love, and that's all we need.
Your total is one big family hug.
Hi, welcome to McDonald's. How can I help you?
Two hash browns and a small coffee.
You know what, for your payment today...
People and memories. All delivered in some adverts. Maybe those marketing people might like to talk to us here at Our Sport. Big news. Let me give you some insight. This Friday, expect a big release from Disbury Family Racing. An insight for you. Superlock Racing have joined forces with Disbury Family Racing yet again. Those of you that live through the dynasty, you've been warned. Watch out. We will deliver. Dale Blaney was quickest down in Florida in practice. The World of Outlaws about to kick off. They've got an All-Stars race first up. Great to see Jason Johnson. Finally living the dream, going out with the World of Outlaws for a full-time drive. His own team. So So well done, Jason. Very proud of what you pulled off there. Sean Dobson left Victoria with some Maxim race cars in the hauler. Had his own private practice at a venue on the way through to the West. So new outfit, long way to haul across that paddock with a brand new outfit to take on the Aussie title. Good luck to Sean Dobson and the team. The guys travelling across the West, please travel safely. We want you to get there all in one piece because we want to talk about it, share about it, and enjoy the racing passion. So strap yourselves in, folks. The people at Thursday Thunder, we're telling it like it is. Can't wait for you to enjoy all the Titan Garages, Sprint Auto Parts, and Scotia Petroleum allow us to bring you each and every week. Drop me a line, Darren at Thursday Thunder. Happy to talk to you about all things Speedway. Enjoy what we've got in front of you. We're back for 2015. I've got to tell you, over the summer break, I had the absolute pleasure of getting to Gillman Speedway on three or four occasions. Without doubt and unashamedly, I tell you, it is the best Speedway venue in Australia. Car, bikes, Gillman is the spot. And boy, do they have some big race meetings. Hopefully, on the line, Samo, hopefully you've got Dave Parker, fresh from Renovation Rescue. Dave, are you there?
Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have told you about hitting my finger.
One nail. They told me it was just one nail and you couldn't hit it.
I tell you what, give me a grater, I'm laughing, right? But put any sort of tool in my hand, and I mean electric tool, and I'm not that good.
Hey, Dave, congratulations to you and your team. The track preparation and the venue this year for some very, very big meetings, basically from Christmas all the way through the end of January. Absolutely pristine. So credit to you.
Yeah, look, it was, Darren, and thanks to all you guys that rolled up. And I even noticed there was a few car teams there, you know, sprint car teams.
The World Series boys all coming out of play.
And Shane was there, and, you know, it was good. But, yeah, look, we always have really good meetings. Look, most of our meetings are pretty good, you know, don't get me wrong. But from January or December 28 meeting all the way through basically to the end of the season is pretty full on. January, February is obviously our best.
Yeah, Dave, cracker meetings. Absolutely.
We've got a grand slam at the end of March, but January and February, we all kick butt then.
Well, people should be booking that in. Mate, January 3, I got down there for the Matt Jones Formula 500 Solo Championships. It was round one, and boy, did that absolutely deliver. Jason Doyle from Justin Sedgman and Rowan Tungate with the end-up results. Mate, the racing was absolutely world-class.
Well, it was, and look what we say all the time, if you put on a good track for these guys, you're going to get good racing, and, you know, that's what we take pride in. We take pride in trying to give them the best dance floor we can, and they'll go for it, you know. Like, there's a lot of prestige in this Aussie title, so
yeah. Mate,
it was
we've got
a good
some...
meeting, it was close, and there was passing, and everything you'd want to ask for. So, look, I was pretty wrapped with that.
Yeah, we got some lovely sidecar shots of some of the meetings that occurred over January, thanks to Judy, but... Mate, Jason Doyle, I just wanted to point him out in particular. Obviously now running with the Grand Prix, he was a standout, wasn't he?
Well, he was. Jason's one of these lads where, you know, there's no bells, no airs, no graces. Comes across as a pretty, you know, a matter-of-fact sort of guy. And, you know, when he wants to get the job done, he's pretty focused. Not unlike Troy Batchelor and even Chris Holder. So, you know, I'm holding big things for him this year in the Grand Prix. Maybe not... You know, I'm saying win the Grand Prix. Don't get me wrong; it's a pretty hard gig to do. But
he's going to mix it with him.
I'm sure that he's going to pull his weight fairly well.
Mate, the Salem Tyre South Australian Sidecar Championships turned out to be a great prelude. The racing, obviously, at your venue there, and also what we saw up at Murray Bridge, unbelievable. Darren Treloar is an absolute wizard on those three wheels.
Yeah, look, Darren, I've said this for many, many years. Like I'm 59 years old. I started Speedway when I was 16 years old, and I saw the Len Boses, I saw the Kim McConnells, I saw the Dean Taylors, I've seen the Glenn O'Briens and the Cleavies and the Robsons, and the whole list goes on. There has not been a sidecar rider in Australia in my time that would even blow wind up Darren Treloar. He is he just gets better and better.
Mate, he absolutely excites. Talk about excites. We just got a couple of shots there of the Headland boys. Would be remiss of me not to mention the your Grand Slam run up at Murray Bridge. The boys have crashed in the final. We've got to paint the picture. They've crashed in the final, come out of four and got slammed into the fence. It was a bit of a concertina. They're laying poleaxed on the track. No one's quite sure what's going to happen. The referee announces that all back in. They stumble back into the pits to grab their spare bike. They come out and they won the thing. It was a fairy tale.
Look, we've all seen soccer. Someone gets kicked in the shins and they carry them off on a stretcher. These guys have got 180 horsepower motorcycles. They've got no brakes and they hit a cement fence, right? Mm. Now, not the dog's barking.
Yeah,
I'm
not happy either, yep.
I'll have to throw the thing at it in a minute. Mm. But they crashed, hit the fence, got up, got their spare bike, went out and won it. Mm. You know, like, you don't...
That fixed the dog. Mate, the crowd erupted. Talking about crowds erupting, on the Grand Slam, the round three, which is down at, back at Gilman again, mate, the heat racing was probably as good a racing I've ever seen on the bike stuff. You could have put a blanket over a number of the races, probably three of the riders, but come that semi-final, you had four riders sail for 1.5 laps, and truly, they were touching each other. They all swapped paint. It was unbelievable.
It was, and it was a good, what they call, clean race. You know, like, everyone's pushing, everyone's shoving, but no one's taking front wheels out and things like that. It was a really good. See, the B final is probably, you know, like, the A final is the most important race, don't get me wrong. But the B final, you've got four riders in it, and only one can get in.
Oh.
So everyone's backed themselves. So you've got the top three in the A final, then the next four are all in the B final, and you can throw a blanket over any four riders are in any B final as a general rule, and you're going to get that. You're going to get that week after week after meeting after meeting.
Well, Dave, a couple of good things come out of that. The racing was awesome. The track you guys produced was absolutely first class. The crowd was on its feet. I haven't seen that at a Speedway venue for some time. They absolutely erupted, and to top the night off, I had a bloody Gilman dog and it was first class.
The Gilman dogs are getting better, I think.
Don't change the recipe.
I saw the chief down there, and he had one in a hand, one in his hand, and one in each pocket.
He didn't want them to sell out, he told me, so he thought he'd better buy two.
Yeah. Now look, we've had a very, very good season, and we've still got some big meetings going on down there.
Dave, last week the Oceania round for the sidecars, Darren Treloar again, absolute standout. It was good to see Mark Playstead get the job done. Gatesy in for third. But I think the real story there was actually the Prince of Port Adelaide. His generosity. He's an absolute character, isn't he?
Look, he is. Well, Joe Jones from the United States was over, and he's on a borrowed bike while he's here because they don't use, and this is something going to be really good in the future because we've organised a frame for him to take home to copy.
Okay,
so
yep.
They can all... USA don't have the same bikes as what we do. So... he borrowed a bike while he was out here. The Prince was reserved for the meeting. And look, to be a reserve for the Oceania is basically the world championship.
Yeah, sidecar championship,
For sidecars. So anyhow, Joe Jones is a fantastic guy, right? Typical Yank, talk, you know? And when he threw a chain in practice, Ronnie Parker went straight up to him and said, "Hey, mate, you can use my bike." Now... Yeah. Ronnie could have gone in the meeting, so that means Ronnie Parker could have gone into a world championship, right?
Yeah.
But no, he gave him his bike, and you know he rode quite well. Ronnie's bike isn't, you know, like the others; it's a little bit slower, and Ronnie's a bit of a tourist as such. Still gets lots of placings and things like that.
He does very well for a tourist.
But gave him the bike, and away we went. And it took Joe, obviously, it was a completely different bike to what he'd been practicing on down here, and did quite well. I think he ended up with 2 seconds and a third or something like that.
It was an awesome gesture. So I guess, mate, the summer season's been absolutely huge. There's more on the way. The Sidecar Masters in the fortnight, that's the next big thing there at the Gilman Speedway.
Yeah, we got the Masters there. Look, I'm not even sure who's entered for it yet. A lot of the guys, you know, will be either coming back from the final round of the Oceania over in Curry, but... You know, I have noticed there's a few like Patterson and from Victoria and guys like that have already ended. So, it'll be another good meeting.
The stars will line up as they deservedly should there at the Gilman. Mate, congratulations again to you and all those that work down there. It's fantastic. Enjoy going. credit to you guys. When the World Series guys are in the house and they tell me they had a great night of Speedway Entertainment, that's the credit you deserve. That's well done.
Yeah, no, it is good, and it's quite surprising the amount of guys that were actually there, you know. So, yeah, look, I'm pretty stoked. And look, Darren, it's no secret that I went to World Series for many, many, many years. Not that I'm a sprint car lover, right, you know, or anything like that. It was, you know, don't get me wrong, I like sprint cars, but I went there to see how you guys run events, and World Series sprint cars gave me a lot of ideas, and if we can pass them on and do a good job, well, you know, it's a win-win for all of us.
Dave, quick little story for you in the house, whether you're aware or not, for the one of the major events we had. Shane Collins from World Series was there, from Speedway Australia, had his four-year-old son. He was sitting on a chrome chair. He'd never been and seen the bikes run before. He'd been plenty of bike races. By halfway through the night, it was heat 7, he was sliding his backside around the back of this aluminium chair, sliding like a passenger, making the noise of the bike. So he may be 4, but you've got a new supporter in that young man right there.
Yeah, look, you know, with the lawns and everything we've got down there and seating and things like that, you look, it's good and very humbling. It's great, you know. And Shane did actually send me a message, you know, of congratulations. And you know, that means a fair bit to us, you know, that sort of stuff. When somebody in that calibre and yourself and the other sprint car drivers and teams that were there, you know, give you a pat on the back, you know, you think, okay, that's... we must have done something right.
No, so, you're doing something right, mate. Go and get some more Gilman dogs ready. We're coming back at you real soon. Keep doing what you're doing, mate. You're doing a great job. And all power to those sidecar and solo boys for what they produced over January. It was awesome.
All right, guys.
All right, mate. We'll catch up to you soon. Wow, Dave really works very hard, but he's got a great team behind him there at Gilman Speedway. If you haven't been, get down there. Check it out. I'm sure you're going to love the 2- and 3-wheel action. We're going to be back right after this with more thunder. Thanks to our good friends at Titan, my mate here decided he'd stick around because we're going to have a chat to a South Australian bloke that was probably on top of his game, Pico.
He was. He's been doing, had a brilliant run through Speed Week and quick time, finished on the podium, a couple of top five finishes, and he'd been doing really well.
Of course, we speak of Brad Keller, probably the second after Veerley, to be honest, as the rising or risen stars in sprint car racing in Australia.
Yep, one of the most improved drivers going around in Australia at the moment. And it's
a huge following went all wrong on night 3 at the Classic. We're going to roll the footage of a crash. If you don't want to watch, turn away, but here it is. Now, it's as innocent a crash as we've probably ever seen. Just a matter of guys all looking for the same bit of track. Brad's up and over. And there's the finish.
That the way the cars come down like that, that's the part that is doing all the damage at the moment. The way they come down on the back wheels.
We'll have one more look at it here. Every week at every track, we see accidents probably bigger and more fierce than this. Not necessarily how big or how fast the accident is. It's just one of those things.
That's right, and you look at it and you think, if you had just rolled over a little bit more, landed on the wing and that sort of thing, but it's just an unfortunate part of our sport at the moment that we're getting a few injuries like this.
And Pico, we're very pleased to say we've got the young man himself, Brad Keller's on the line. Brad, thanks for joining us on Thursday Thunder.
Yeah, no, thanks for having me, guys.
Mate, first of all, can we let everyone know, how are you doing?
Look, I'm going pretty well, actually. It's been a tough couple of weeks on everyone, making sure I'm okay. I've had thousands of phone calls and messages, but I'm on the improve, and the pain's a lot better than what it has been. Yeah,
mate. The short answer is that you are good to go. You will recover fully from this.
Yeah, absolutely. Bob reports that it'll heal up to be as strong as it was prior to the crash, which is very positive, obviously. And you know, I'm pretty lucky that I haven't done any real severe damage. It's just compression fractures and the spine's still in line. And, there's nothing too twisted up, so I'm pretty fortunate.
Yeah. Mate, compression fractures T3, T4, we're told, in the middle of the shoulder blades, basically for people unmedical like myself, Pico. Mate, the crash, we've watched it back over and over here. It just was one of those things. At what minute did you know you're in trouble?
Well, it was a pretty big crash. I got quite a bit of air, and the bigger hits didn't really feel it. But as soon as it landed on that chassis and it bottomed out, I knew instantly. As soon as it landed, and I don't think the wing had stopped flapping, and I was screaming. It knocked the wind out of me, and obviously the belt's being pulled down. The pressure on my back was just enormous, and I was just in agony, and I knew instantly what I'd done. I called for the paramedic, and they knew sort of what I'd done. So, it was a pretty obvious thing. The pain was just unbearable. Yeah,
intense. They tell me it's pretty full on. Mate, I don't want to dwell on the accident part of it, but I think it's important that people know that you are fine and will recover. The response from the paramedics and the crash team there at Warrnambool was sensational, wasn't it?
I was. It's a real credit to them, to be honest. I don't know if they've done a lot of training or why they're so skilled up on it, but the way they got me out of the car, I was a bit nervous about them cutting a lot of the things that they did. But
the story I heard, you didn't want them to cut anything.
Yeah, no, that's it. So, the way that they did that was remarkable, and, they picked me up from the front of the car so they could lift me at the top and all those sort of things. It was really, really well done. I've really got to thank them and the guys at Premier Speedway for doing such a good job and looking after me.
Yeah, Brad, us too. As spectators, obviously extremely scary to see one of our mates out there hurt in any situation, but to know they're in those best hands of people that know what they're doing is very comforting to us, and it must be for you, the competitors.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, no, that's exactly right. And you want those on your side. It sort of, it makes me really appreciate running at venues like that do have those guys on the infield if something does go wrong. So,
lot to be said about that. Mate, on the positive, I believe the hospital was inundated with messages, people trying to get to see you. Facebook went into meltdown. I've never seen such a response to a situation where we didn't really know what was happening first up. But the Speedway public were absolutely strong in their support for you. That must be so humbling.
Oh, yeah, it is. We're all fierce competitors out there, but when someone gets hurt or wrecks, everyone's there picking up the pieces for you. And I just got to thank my crew who got the car back in the truck. And, we had evidently crews from people from all sorts of crews helping us.
Absolutely.
Getting the truck loaded. And, it really does go a long way to know that it is a big community. And, if anyone else ends up in the same situation, I'd offer them the same, it's great like that. And, that's just the great thing about Speedway. It is a big community.
Absolutely. I think, and Pico's here, we're just nodding how great it is that the community gets together. And we do fight and we do bitch and we do race hard, but at the end of the day, we are as one.
That's right. And, everyone's here for the same reason. We all love the sport, and when somebody's hurt, we all pitch in and do whatever we can to help out. So, yeah, it was a fantastic response by everyone down there.
Brad, I felt sorry for your wife, Kelly, not being at the venue, being so far away. She obviously did it tough there for a little while till she got to you. She's been the rock in all this for you, I believe.
Yeah, she has. She's done a great job around here. She's obviously been off work looking after me and haven't been out of drive, so she's taken me to quite a few medical appointments. But it was pretty hard for her. I mean, I'm a nervous watcher if I'm watching a race. It's always probably more nerve-wracking when you're not there. I'd rather be racing than watching it.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I felt for her. And it was one of those injuries where I knew I'd be okay, but I was in the car and, no one else had any idea. And the paramedics were obviously trying to do a job and, not letting too much information go. And, I understand where everyone was, probably more anxious than I was. But, it's just one of those things. Everyone's, pretty happy that I'm going to be okay. And, I'm
Mate,
very fortunate.
It's understatement. We are thrilled to know that you're going to be okay.
Absolutely.
Don't understate your presence and your status in the whole Speedway family, mate. The Speedway people from across Australia, mate, the phone calls and messages that I got trying to people to find out firsthand that you were all right, And it's just so relieved to know that you're going to be okay.
Yeah, no, it is like that. And, you know, I sort of, for about 2 days there, I laid there and I thought, I don't know if I'm in the right sport. And, you know, it's just one of those things. A mate of mine got injured playing golf a few weeks ago. So it doesn't matter what sport you play,
absolutely.
Injuries. Yeah. They look at Brent Riley at the moment, who's got a fractured skull from playing football. You know, it doesn't matter what you play. So I was laying there for 2 days thinking, is this for me? And as soon as I started to feel better, started missing racing. And me and Dad have been planning some big things for next year with some new equipment. So,
I've got to tell you, mate, there's a few smiles on the dials in the studio here
good.
To hear those
yep.
words.
That's what we want to hear.
Yep, but I'm actually getting quite hungry, just sort of missing all the racing we're meant to be doing now. So I've got obviously a few months to try and get myself right, and probably going to have to do quite a bit of physio and rehab to try and get the back strong. And you want to come back next year ready to go, and hopefully it'll allow us to extend our season a bit more, obviously not running as much this year. So
that's the plan, Brad, rehabilitation for the rest of this year, get it right, make sure it's right, and look forward to a big 2015-16 season.
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, your preparation's the most important thing with what we do, and if we can prepare ourselves probably better for next year, it'll help us rather than trying to rush back late this year, you know, and not be right. You know, you might have a little tumble and niggle it, and next minute you're back at square one. So I'd rather just sort of rebuild fully for next year and come back out for our sponsors.
Yeah. Mate, absolutely thrilled that you're doing well. A little bit of self-indulgence. When your accident happened, I was in the corporate area on top of Mount Max, and I was with some very good friends of yours, the Johnsons. And to watch what was unfolding in front of us, in front of 10,000 odd people, I think, Pico, were there.
Yeah.
Through their eyes, as you, their very, very close friend, was rather heartbreaking. The information that was coming out was minute. All they were telling us is that you were okay. Clearly, from what was happening, there was issues. Mm. And we were just sitting on the edge of our seats waiting to get something positive. It was like nothing I've ever experienced.
Yeah, like I said, it's like watching, you know, I guess, as a spectator, you know, you really don't know what's going on out there. And I was probably the most content out of everyone now. I'm in a lot of pain. I sort of understood I had a back injury, and, you know, I would have liked the microphone in my hand just so I could let everyone know I was okay. But, all the emergency services were fending everyone off, so it was a bit of a tough one. And I know commentators can't say a lot because they can't give out false information.
No.
And, you know, all they can say is you're okay. And, you know, like I said, I felt bad at the time sitting on the track holding the meeting up for so long.
Not at all.
I wanted them to drag the car out of the...
That would have been the least of their worries, I think, Brad. So.
It was not a consideration by anyone in the venue or competing in the venue.
Yeah, I understand that, but that's just the way it is. You just want to get out of there. And, you know, they said, oh, we want to get a drip in there before we get out of here. And I said, just get me out of here. So they eventually just took off. So,
well, we appreciate your concern for the event, but we're more concerned about you. Mate, the one person over and above Kelly that is Dad. He is the heart and soul of your race team. It all happens in and around you and him. How's he handling the whole deal?
He's missing racing. I offered to him if he wants to put someone in the car for a while, he can. I won't have a problem with it. We've obviously got a lot of sponsors on board, and we toiled with the idea of maybe running it, but this time of year it's just so hard to get someone experienced and someone that's, you know, ready to go and going to look after your equipment. And other than putting, you know, someone young in, it's probably just not going to work out. So, you know, he's missing it like you wouldn't believe. He's probably taken it harder than me because I've sort of been rested up and sleeping a lot.
Yeah.
So he's missing it like you wouldn't believe.
Well, you can let him know after this interview. I reckon there'd be 20 or 30 people looking for a crew chief. So he'll be much sought after. Mate, I was talking to some of your major sponsors in the last week, just obviously discussing your health and where you're at. I've never seen such a more supportive group than the Rosenberg Machinery Group. Mate, irrelevant as to whether you're racing, it's your health was their only concern. It was absolutely heartwarming to have that conversation with Nathan from that group.
That's probably been the most, probably the best part about the whole thing. You know, I've had sponsors come to my house and they said, Brad, all I want you to do is get it better and we'll be on board next year. So, you know, that's been, you know, quite a relief. Like, you don't really know where it leaves you with a lot of them. You know, obviously, you know, you're trying to do the right thing by them. And, you know, it's just been really reassuring. And, you know, just takes that bit of stress out of it for you.
I'd be surprised you didn't pick up more support, mate, such as been the outpouring from the Speedway community. Brad, I'm getting the big wind-up here, mate. I just want to reiterate to everybody out there, you're doing fine. The recovery should be full and complete. You're looking forward to competing again next season after you've rehabilitated, and all should be good to go.
Yeah, absolutely, and we look forward to it. We're going to be hanging out for a race meeting come September, October, I can tell you.
Mate, you just got to make me one promise. Can you do that?
Yeah.
Don't do it again.
Well, I've got some safety solutions that I've, you know, we've spoken to some people about, and people have had similar injuries, and we're going to implement them with some seats and stuff like that, and just hope we don't land that way. It's that simple. It, you know, fit those, you know, some of that padding in the seat, compression foam and stuff like that, and just do all we can. I mean, we're probably a little bit complacent with a couple of things like that, but, you know, certainly we'll be looking into all that sort of stuff over the off-season to try and, you know, stop something like that. But it's just the way it landed. It's just a freak thing.
Yeah, and, one of those things.
If it happens again, it's, you know, just another unfortunate thing. You just move on.
Yeah. Mate, stay out front where there's no other cars. There's no issue.
That's right. Yeah, I mean, the classic's one of those races where everyone's desperate for points and each move counts. But like I said, it's just the way it landed.
Yeah, one of those things.
I'm not going to go out there half-hearted next time. I'll race like I did this year. You know,
elbows up and back into it.
I know it's a freak thing. It's just, you know, yeah.
Yep. Absolutely one of those things. Brad, really appreciate you joining us. I'm thrilled that you've taken the time to let people know that you are doing well and will fully recover. Mate, please take care of yourself. Send our love to Kelly and the family. I know they've been a great support to you, and we are so thrilled as a Speedway community to know that you're going to be back on track, fitter and stronger than ever before.
You know, I'd like to just thank you, everyone that's helped me out, and obviously everyone for their messages, and apologies if I haven't got back to everyone. I think I have got back to most people, but thanks to everyone that's supported me through these last couple of weeks, and we look forward to next year, and thanks to Thursday Thunder for letting me come on the show.
No, mate, our pleasure. You take care, and we'll catch up real soon. And as soon as you're up for that cold beer, you let me know.
Yeah, thanks, Darren.
All right, mate, take care.
Thanks, Mark.
Mate, that is one great racer. And as he said, Pico, it's just one of those things.
Yeah, it was. It's just one of those freak things. Like I said earlier, if the car had moved a little bit further and just landed on the wing or landed on the side or something, we wouldn't even be sitting here talking about it.
My concern, though, there's been four crashes this year where there's been broken backs or something similar.
Yep.
Who's looking into it?
That's right, we've got to stop it.
We've got to look into it. Someone needs to be responsible. Mate, we've got some footage. It's from the guys at Loud Pedal. We're going to show that straight back after this break. So we'll take a quick break, thanks to Titan, and we've got some super cool footage coming from Loud Pedal.
Looking forward to seeing it.
It's always a pleasure of mine when we get a guest here in the studio, let alone when they actually dominate the studio with their car all around me. Welcome to Brella Island from Murray Bridge.
How are you, mate?
Mate, just a quick trip down the freeway.
Yeah, just down the road for us. It's pretty good.
You had no idea the extremes we would go to get your car all around us in the set.
Nah, Sammy's done pretty well up there. I'm, yeah, a bit surprised.
Yeah. Fat heads, look at that. Maybe that's appropriate. I don't know. That's scary. Mate, tell us your story. I've been around Speedway probably forever, and I reckon you've been there just as long.
Just about. I remember, well, pretty much as long as I've been coming to the racetrack, you've been around there some way or another. With
scary, really.
Yeah.
Mate, you're only that big. What happened?
I don't know. I think you were a little bit younger back then too, so, yeah. We can ask the same question.
One point all. Mate, you got involved in wingless racing last year and absolutely hit the scene in a big, big way. Your presentation is first class. It's an absolute credit to you.
Yeah, we try and do what we can. I mean, you know, there's nothing better than having a new car or, you know, something that looks new when you go out to wash it and you look after it a bit nicer. So we try and keep the cars looking decent and, you know, look after the sponsors at the same time.
Mate, you must have done something pretty right. You won Rookie of the Year last year, best presented, and every time you hit the track, you were absolutely a contender. Look at that. That presentation is absolutely unreal. It's fantastic.
Yeah, a lot of it's a little bit of spit and polish, and Wade makes it look pretty good with the photos and Pico and all the other guys who take the photos. So.
Well, we've got a couple of shots there, mate. We'll jump ahead. You got your backside into a speed car now. What's going on?
Yeah, I had an absolute ball. Can't thank Mark Harrington and Nelson Dwyer. So,
Harry.
Harry, yeah.
Bacon Harry.
That'd be the one, yes. The athlete, as we call him.
That's an oxymoron. Sorry, Harry.
Yeah, we, you know, Ali sort of gave us a chance at the start of the year and offered us, you know, a chance to have a go and, you know, we jump at it with both feet because it's, you know, I don't think I've ever heard someone say they don't want to race one of those things.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Now, let me go back to the wingless. You've got a great setup in the shop there, obviously. You've got a number of cars ready. But what attracted me this year is that you've done a deal with the Leukemia Foundation. What? Tell us about that.
Basically, we've tried to get something happening with the Leukemia Foundation. My crew chief from last year, he has leukemia.
That's Craig Taylor?
That's it, yes. Mm-hmm. And his dad asked us if we'd like to get involved with doing the World's Greatest
Shave. Hold that shot there. Wow, mate, that's an awesome effort to do that.
Yeah, that's actually Mal there, sitting at the table with his arms crossed, looking pretty happy as usual.
At the Pleasure Dome itself, Murray Bridge?
That's the one, yeah. And Mal asked us if we'd like to do the shave, and we sort of went one further and decided we'd do something with the foundation, actually put them on the car, so that way they can use it later on for some of their promotional work and actually get them some more exposure.
Some absolutely fantastic feedback. I think I've seen pictures of your car here, there and everywhere, if not for your blue hair and all sorts of... Facebook's been inundated.
Yeah, it's good. Like I said, we're trying to get as much exposure as we can. You know, we've run it at the track, obviously, now, but we're trying to use the car for a lot of their events as well. Obviously, Clipsal coming up. We're going to have the car on display there in their colours.
Part of the Speedway Australia display?
Yep. Shane Collins has offered us a spot there, which is awesome.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and, you know, they do a lot of fundraising and stuff at things like the Big Bash with the cricket, and, you know, hopefully we'll have it available for stuff like that for them.
Awesome. Mate, a couple of big races coming up. The South Australian title this weekend at Murray Bridge. 48 of the best wingless drivers are about to hit the Pleasure Dome.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be tough, and she's going to be about 41 degrees today, so she's going to be hot on and off the track. So.
If you see a puddle somewhere up there, it's probably me, so please step over it, people.
Yeah, there's some big names. A lot of the good guys are already in town. Dan Hardigan rocked up last week, and you know, there's quite a few good guys that are coming for that. So.
The following weekend, out to Speedway City, the Australian title in your own backyard. Got to be a good thing.
Yeah, exactly. We sort of geared ourselves with this new car pretty much just for the title. We've only run the new car in Adelaide since we gave it a shakedown at Avalon to start with.
Yeah.
Yeah, and probably a little disappointing with some of the numbers. I sort of expected a couple more cars to be heading here, but when you look at the list, all the good drivers are still here. So, you know, it's still going to be hard work.
Mate, there'd be 60 of the best. I think whoever walks away with it, I had a look at the entry list earlier today, and I think any one of probably 20 guys could win that.
Yeah, that's it. You know, obviously, we've got some pretty good drivers getting around here, so you add in, you know, the likes of Hibbert and the Wren boys, Daniel Storer from Victoria, and, you know, Hardigan and, you know, the guys from WA, it's pretty hard.
Mate, it's a hotbed of racing, so that's all things wingless. Now tell me about this speed car. Not having one and put my backside in one of those things, they look so exciting.
Yeah, they are. Yeah, like I said, I got to do a couple laps a while ago at practice at the bridge. Unfortunately, uh-huh. We had a couple of mechanical dramas that night.
Is that the night Harry was working on it?
That was the night that Harry just worked on it. So, yeah, we got all fixed up and finally get to actually have a proper steer on Saturday night out here. And
They tell me it was like a duck to water. That's the story I'm getting.
Well, yeah, surprisingly, I was quite comfortable in the car from the first couple laps, even at practice with it. And, yeah, we seemed to sort of tried to stay out of trouble and not do anything silly our first night, but we managed to move forward and yeah.
So where does it take you? Where does the speed car take you for the rest of this year?
We've got one more club show in Adelaide, then the three nights over Easter, we'll run with the Super Sedan guys at Watertown, Murray Bridge and then Adelaide again.
Wow, okay. Three nights, that's big, yep.
Yeah, I can't wait. And then I think there's one more show at Murray Bridge that's been now moved to April with the AmCar title up there, so.
Surely you're living the dream.
Having an absolute ball too. I mean, you know, I've sort of took 30 years to get into a race car, to be in a position where I could do it and do it properly. And now we're in it, just try and do as many laps as we can and it's sort of hopefully paying off.
Your team around you, there's always a large group. The social group's very, very strong. Always seem to be having a lot of fun. I know you do take it seriously because I see the look in your eyes, but when you're not in that car, there's probably not a group in that pits having more fun than the guys with your race team.
Yeah, we try and do what we can. I mean, you know, we've grown up around the sport, and if you can't get on with everybody, it makes it a very, very long night in the pits. It's great to be in a position where we have guys come up to us and ask us for help, and, you know, we try and help everyone out, and hopefully that way, if we ever need a hand, it's there for us as well, so.
Mate, by day, when you're not the Superman in the race car, how do you fund all this?
Well, I'm a glazier, self-employed, so we work our butt off to, do what we can and sort of now finally got to a stage where we can afford to actually do some of this stuff.
The Dragon's a bit of a Facebook junkie. I see all your posts. Mate, you're everywhere. You're putting windows in Adelaide, you're in Murray Bridge, you're down the southeast, you're in the mid-north.
Yeah, that's it. We do quite a bit of commercial stuff. Some of the big jobs around Adelaide, we quite often pop our heads up and, get to play with some pretty cool stuff.
Must be doing it right. So the dream's being lived. Where does it take us? What's the ultimate thing for Brett Island? What do we put our backside in? What's going to tick the box?
Yeah, well, that's the big question. I mean, obviously, everybody would love to go and do World Series. Whether that had ever happened will be another story, but
Is that in the plans? Is that the long-term goal, should you be able to get there?
Financially, probably not for myself. If, obviously need a lot of backing to do that sort of stuff. Mm-hmm. Someone like Brock Hallett's moved that path. He, was going all right in the speed car and has now moved that way and gearing that sort of thing, hopefully for it to happen for him. Financially for us, probably the speed car looks like it may be the next step. Mm. Purely for the fact you're limited with shows, so you can't sort of outspend too much unless you want to do a lot of travelling. And as long as you're not having any motor issues with those, they seem to be sort of around the mark.
Keep Harry off the spanners, you'd probably be right with that.
Yeah.
Mate, your racing impresses me. You're always at the sharp end. The presentation is probably unequalled in the wingless group. But I note that you also support many of the other sections. I see your name on a number of other cars, and I know firsthand that it's assistance with not just equipment but money to help the other teams. You obviously enjoy that.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, like I said, we like to help people out where we can. We get on really well with a lot of guys in Victoria. I spend probably most of January and December in Victoria with whatever series or,
I knew someone over there had to have a friend.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. And some of the friends over there are surprised that they've got any to begin with. So. Yeah, so we spend quite a bit of time over there and we help them out and hopefully when they come over here we can offer them, if it's only a bed or somewhere to stay, we do what we can.
It's always something exciting happening with Brett Island Racing, there's no doubt about it. If you see him at the track, folks, get along, say g'day. The car will stand out, there's no doubt. You'll see what he's doing and, mate, wish you all the best the coming weekend. SA title at Murray Bridge this weekend.
That's it.
And then the big dance, Australian wingless title, Speedway City, the following weekend.
Yeah. Woo!
She's going to be big.
Yeah, we can't wait. New sponsor on the car for the title. So, yeah, hopefully we can do
them justice. Do we know who that is yet? Or is that we're waiting for the big unveil?
Yeah, we might wait for the unveil. We got a,
I hate that.
We had someone special doing the paint scheme for us too, so hopefully it all looks nice. Andy Hibbert always does a great job with our cars, so we've got someone to help him out with the design this time. Yeah, and hopefully we do him justice on the track.
We'll be looking for a sneak peek next week. We'll see what we can do. We'll send our trusty cameraman around, poke the camera through the shed. Mate, good luck. We'll keep watching what you're doing this year. Keep doing what you're doing. You're doing a great job. It's an absolute pleasure watching you do what you do on Speedway.
Beautiful. Thanks, Daz.
Man, get there. Watch this guy. We're going to be back after this. We've got some more thunder, some exciting news coming your way right after this. Well, you wouldn't believe it. They've all come out of the hills today. At great expense to management, we got Pico at the desk. G'day, mate. Welcome back.
Thanks, Des. Good to be here.
Was Father Christmas kind?
Yes. I'm just getting over the Thursday Thunder Christmas party, but we did all right, actually.
Glad to hear it. Mate, the weekend, the Mandy 360 Series hit down at Mount Gambier. It was the Spud race.
Yep.
Dedicated to Tyson Perez. Now, I know you were good friends of his.
Yep.
Mate, it's actually grown to be one of the biggest races on the calendar, hasn't it? Especially for the 360 boys.
Yeah, it sure is. They all put a lot of effort in to make sure that they get there. 25 or so cars signed in this week. And, yeah, it was a great night and all to celebrate a great guy.
Mate, Tyson passed away 2010, I think it was,
yep.
In America with his great mate, Travis Rylett, who was out here again for the race.
Yep.
And history will show that he won it back-to-back. I remember quite vividly the phone calls coming through that Tyson had been injured.
Yep.
And as to what unfolded over the next 24, 48 hours, the Speedway community actually lived that as a whole. It was rather horrific.
Yeah, it sure did. I got a phone call, it was about 5 o'clock in the morning, and explained everything that went on, and I got a phone call from Paul Carruthers, actually. I can still remember it. And I couldn't believe it. And spoke to Deb, Tyson's mum, that night.
Yep.
And yeah, it was just a real shock and a real tragedy, actually. So,
mate, not everyone knew Tyson, which is hard to believe. He was larger than life. If you're in the pit area and Tyson was there, fair chance you're going to see him or hear him.
Yeah, you would have heard him. Mm-hmm. Yeah, always hear him before you saw him. So, but he was a cracking bloke and did so much for sprint cars.
Yeah.
Here in Australia and in America, spent 6 or 7 years in America with Travis. Sammy Swindell, he did a couple of years with Sammy.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was just real tragedy.
Man, I'm constantly surprised the memorial races, they come, they go.
Yep.
This seems it's going to stay for a long time. The feeling's very deep for Tyson.
Yeah, and it's good that Mandy's hooked up with it, and they look like they're going to throw their support behind it for a good number of years now. And I'm sure it's going to grow each and every year.
Mm. Mate, on the weekend down there, we had our cameras down there and we asked the question, what does the race mean to you? We spoke to Tim Van Ginnegan, Tony Bartlett, Travis Rylett, Mandy Searle herself, and Chad Eli. Here's the responses we got. Roll the tape, Sammy.
What does the Spud race mean to you?
It means a fair bit. Not just to me, to Tamara Lumsden. She was very good friends with Tyson. And we try and do this 360 race every year and we'll try and continue to do it. She puts a lot of time and effort into it, and we had a bit of bad luck a few weeks ago, so we didn't get to do our paint scheme we usually do, but we'll do it bigger and better again next year.
G'day, Tony. What does the Spud race mean to you?
It's very important to me because Spud came out on the road with me and learnt to be a sprint car mechanic, and he was as keen as mustard but knew nothing, and by the end he was pound for pound as good as anybody.
G'day, Travis. What does the Spud race mean to you?
I tell you, there's no words that can describe what the Spud race means to me. You know, as good as friends as Tyson and I were, it's just, you know, it's nice to come over here and race in his honor. It takes a very special person to have a memorial race in someone's honor. And last year when we came over and were able to run that thing and have Spud's mother here with us, and it's very emotional, I could say the least, you know. But it's very good, and, you know, I can see him out there cheering us on, and he'd want nothing less than a win.
Hi, Mandy. What does the Spud race mean to you?
Oh, it makes me speechless. It's a really, really special event. It's to tribute a young guy that died in the prime of his life. He was a great supporter of 360s. I'd known him since he was a little kid. So it's very, very special to me. And to have Travis Rylett come out from the States and run with it, who was with him at the accident, it just gives me goosebumps talking about it. I really can't put it into words.
Hi Chad, what does the Spud race mean to you?
It's hard to put it in words. I don't think there's any words to describe what it means to me, but I can tell you now it's a 150% emotion, and there'll be nothing left on the table tonight.
I think you can see it firsthand there, Pico. It's powered by emotion, that race.
Yeah, it certainly is. And like you look at the podium the last couple of years, like this year we had Travis Rylett win it, Chad Eli and Harley Bishop come in third.
Yeah.
And all three of those guys were really good close mates yeah. of Spud. And it just shows how much they want to win it. And Travis just keeps pipping them every year.
Some irony there. Travis, they tell me, flew 20 hours out of Texas to be here.
Yep.
Come from a cold climate.
Yep.
Wins the race. Lost the drinking competition on the Sunday.
He lost it big time. Photos I've seen, he's sleeping. And this is, I think the sun was almost still up, so... But yeah, he had a long flight out here and a big emotional win, and yeah, he deserved a couple of drinks after it.
Carries his heart in his sleeve. A big shout out to Mandy herself, the first lady of all things 360 Sprint Cars.
Yep.
She's doing a great job. That whole series, she's the absolute life source of that.
Yeah, I can't speak highly enough of Mandy. She's so easy to deal with. Like any time that she wants anything, I'm more than happy to help her out, whatever I can.
We've got the point score there currently for the 360 series. The mainline, Dynalog, Dynalometer, and all those other loggers that are tied up with it, they're all in there. Scotty Boguski sitting on 2753. Sammy Putland, his mate from up the hill, your neck of the woods, 2750. Now, the tip is this week they're at Hamilton. The event may not go ahead because of the heat.
I think they're at Horsham this week.
Horsham.
I don't want to.
You sure it's not Hamilton?
I don't know. I know it starts with a H.
I'm sure they're going to be there. The guys know where they're going. We don't know. However, if that race event doesn't happen, it means they'll go into Mildura for the final head-to-head.
Head-to-head.
He who finishes in front takes the gold.
Takes it. And I wouldn't even forget about Smooch. Brenton Farah sitting in third place there.
And he started on fire.
Yeah, if the front two don't be on their game that night, old Smooch might do all right too.
Could sneak it away and let it done. We've got some footage here. Ricey was unbelievable with his footage.
Yeah.
He got a highlights package for us. Sam, if we can roll that tape. Just want to point out some of the guys. That's Travis on the inside there at the start of the final. Man, it was hammer on down for the whole race.
Yeah, it was. And Jack Lee there in going back to the 360. He always runs the Spud race. And you find a couple of the guys always come out to run the Spud race from the four turns or step back into the 360 to have a run in it. So, yeah.
Mate, they tell me the track was really, really racy. I was down there for the World Series over Christmas.
Yep.
And then they had the Kings. I thought the Kings, the track was probably a little bit too good.
Yeah, yeah.
But they tell me the track was as racy as it's ever been down there for the Spud race. So all credit to the curators down there getting it right.
Yep. I spoke to Harley during the week, and he loved the track. He said it was great. And you see him going around the outside there and... it's a credit to the guys down there. Billy Barrows, they always do such a great job down there at Mount Gambier.
I see Deb, the mother of Tyson, was there again with stepfather Pete.
Yep.
Great to see them still involved.
Yeah, Pete would go to any speedway in Australia if he can. He used to do it 30 years ago with World Series. He used to go all over the place. And awesome people, Deb and Tuck. And I'm really glad that I can call them friends.
What's going on there, boys? Was there music playing that we missed? Yeah. It was a dance routine?
Yeah, they're spinning out, and poor old Colin Barker's going over again. But, Tim Van Gittingen going around the outside there. He's been doing really well, actually, too.
He's having a great year. Yeah. Pretty impressive to what he's bringing to the table.
Yeah, yep. And, of course, he had American out here Lucas Wolf. And all getting ready there for the A Main. And they leave the pole car off for the four wide there.
Yeah, there's a salute great sign of respect there Spud himself.
Yep.
Mind you, I don't think Spud would ever start on the front row, would he?
No.
He would have been too busy helping everyone else.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't have thought that Spud would have started on the front row, but he knew how to set up a car. He was a wizard at setting up a car. But he would have been looking down on them all and telling them all what they were doing wrong. Don't worry about that.
Well, it was nice to see there was no rain the last couple of years. He's shown his distaste.
It's the first year that we haven't had the possibility of rain, or it hasn't rained during the night. But it was good to actually be there and not have a rain.
fall down on us.
Yeah, no, we don't need that. Mate, it was a great event. All power to Mandy for continuing to do that on, to the team that keep backing that, and especially to Mount Gambier Speedway. A big thank you to them for backing this race year in, year out. It's a credit to them.
That's right, exactly. They do a brilliant job down there.
Mate, it's a pleasure. Like bringing it to you. If you want to check that out on the Mount Gambier website, the whole racing footage is there, thanks to Ricey. So, Pico, thanks for coming down from the hill. I look forward to seeing you on the weekend. I think we got some big racing on the hill this weekend.
Yeah, looking forward to it.
We got more right after this. You're watching Thursday Thunder with him and me. Well, I guess that's about it for Thursday Thunder. We're back after Christmas and a time that I really enjoy. Great opportunity to catch up with family and friends and catch up with all the people I don't see for the whole year. We chase the whole Speed Week thing, and probably the last time the Dragon will be doing that, because young Jack himself will be taking off on the 400-500 series next year. So I guess a whole new world awaits. I'm a bit concerned with the speed car world. Don't hear a lot coming out of there that's looking good for the Pro Series. Very concerned as to where that's going to go going forward. On the positive, though, I do hear that there's going to be a potentially a big race, speed car race, in Adelaide. Very close to the city. Maybe not north of the city like some would expect. The power and the passion of all things Speedway, of course, continually drives the sport. And I guess it comes home to roost when we see some of our friends hurt. The fact that they have been hurt and hurt so badly just reminds us each and every day that the sport we play is dangerous. Don't ever forget, Speedway will bite. Take every precaution we need to take. Those of you in charge of following up on safety, please make it happen. Sometimes we have to be protected from ourselves, so I ask you, please do what you can do. There's so many stories unfolding across the whole of Australia with Speedway at the moment. Most of them are fantastic. The big sprint car boys heading out west, fantastic. Some convoys, the photos that we're seeing as the boys head across to the west, some interesting stuff there. Kangaroo count, I hear Mouse Green's got three, Trevor Green got three, Mouse's kangaroos, cleaned them up, and Danny Reid, he got one. Apparently Danny had to get off the road to get his, but that might be a whole new different story. The World Series teams heading to the west to finish up over there. What a countdown that's going to be. Can't wait to see the outcome and who will be the World Series champion this year in probably the most turmoilish years of all things World Series. Absolutely sad in the Dragon to watch the World Series guys race at Murray Bridge and then drive past Speedway City, where another event was happening, to head west. A number of the teams were down at Gilman watching the bikes. Don't care who's right, don't care who's wrong in the argument. All I know is that I was robbed from watching eight of the best sprint car teams going round from competing head-to-head. Sort it out, people. Whoever's responsible, get together at a table and let's sort it out for once and for all. The sport is bigger than the people having the blues. Sydney Speedway continues to dominate. They're doing it right. Those of you running Speedway venues, if you're not quite sure what to do or how to entertain, just go to Sydney, check it out. Take some notes. You'll know what you're doing. Till I see you next week, you enjoy all things Speedway. Hope you have a great weekend. Please keep cool. We've got some great footage to leave you with called Living Louder, taken from Valvoline Speedway this year, put together by Darren Shaddock. Till I see you again, I'm the Red Dragon, or Darren Disbury to his friends. Look forward to catching you next week back here on Thursday Thunder.
Ready?
Where'd we go from there?
Go.